Hello everyone, myself Sanjay Udge, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to discuss three-phase star system. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to analyze concepts of three-phase star circuits. Guideline: introduction. Relation between line current and phase current for star system. Mathematical expression for line voltage and the phase voltage. Numerical based on star connected system. Acknowledgement. Introduction. Basic concepts of three-phase balanced system. In the last video, we discussed delta types three-phase system. A system is said to be a balanced, or rather than a system is said to be a balanced supply when the three voltages, three phases are having same magnitude but differs in a phase difference of 120 degree. Similarly, a load is said to be balanced when these three loads are having same nature, that is RL, RC or RLC, carries the same phase currents. So in three phase systems, you will find delta type connections or star type connections. Definition: line current, it is the current flowing between the two lines. Phase current, it is the current flowing to a particular phase. Line voltage, it is the voltage between two lines. Phase voltage, it is the voltage across individual phase. The phase sequence, the order in which all these three voltages attains their maximum values. Generally, the phase sequence is R, Y and then B. Relation between line and the phase currents for star system. For star system, line current is equal to the phase current. Exercise: in three phase balance load, what is the value of three phase impedances? In the three phase balanced load, all these three loads are having same value and the same nature. Answer: in three phase balanced load system, each impedances will have equal values. They will carry same currents, line or phase currents, because in star system we will find both line current and the phase currents are same. Mathematical expression for line voltage and the phase voltage. Here I will draw a three phase system. This is R, Y and this is B. This is IR, IB and IY. This is a neutral fourth line. This is VRN. This is VYN and this is VBN. Here I will write which are the phase voltages: VRN, VYN, VBN. These are the phase voltages. What about line? Line voltages are VRY, VYB, VBR. These are the these line voltages. Now it is required to find out the relation between this line voltage and the phase voltage. For that I will draw a phasor diagram or vector diagram. This is being Vrn, 120 degree delayed by Vyn, and this is Vbn. All these are 120 degree. For the sake of simplicity, I will not show the angle. So all these three are 120 degree apart. It is required to find out the line voltage. For example, Vry. Vry is equals to Vr minus Vy. Minus Vy, for minus Vyn, I will draw this being minus Vyn. I will find out resultant of these two vectors using a parallelogram method. So this is line voltage Vry. Now let us denote O, this point Q, this point S. Let us draw a perpendicular from point S, a perpendicular SP on line OQ. This is say P. From the geometry, OQ is equals to 2 times OP, where OQ is equals to VL or VRY. OQ is equals to 2 times OP is equal to OS cos of 30 degree. V line, that is VRY, is equals to 2 times OS is what? It is VPH, cos 30 is root 3 by 2. So finally I can write this VL is equal to root 3 times VPH. It means that line voltage is equals to root 3 times the phase voltage for a star connected system. A 3 phase star connected balanced load having each impedance is ZPH is equal to 8 plus J10 supplied with a voltage 400 volts 50 hertz supply. It is required to find out the IPH, phase current, line current, phase voltage, power factor, then active power, reactive power, and apparent power. Since the system is balanced, it means that all the impedances, 3 impedances, are having same value and nature. Let us concentrate our numerical with respect to a single phase. So to find out IPH, it is required to know VPH and ZPH. Okay. So what is ZPH? It is 8 plus 10J. ZPH, which is in a rectangular form, since we want IPH, which is equal to VPH upon ZPH, it is a division. Convert this rectangular form into polar form, comes out to be 12.81 angle 51.34 degrees. So next, what is VPH? For VPH, it is VL upon root 3. So 400 divided by root 3 comes out to be 231 volts. Now we can find out IPH. IPH is equal to VPH 231 upon ZPH 12.81 angle 51.34 degree. So in this way, using calculator, we got the value of IPH, which is equals to 18.03 angle minus 51.34 degree. So this is IPH, which is also equals to line current, because in star connected system both IPH and IL are same. Now, power factor. Power factor, it is equals to cos of 51.34 degree, comes out to be 0.62 lagging. Here, the power factor is lagging because the current is lagging. Why the current is lagging? Because it's an inductive circuit, so voltage leads currents by this angle 51 degrees. Now, coming towards active power, root 3 VLIL cos of theta comes out to be, putting value of VL 400 volts, IL 18.03 cos of 51 degree comes out to be 7.8 kilowatt. Q, reactive power, root 3 VLIL sin theta comes out to be, again putting value of VL and IL, comes out to be 9 kilovolt ampere reactive. Similarly, apparent power is equal to root 3 VL into IL, put value of VL IL, comes out to be 12 kilovolt ampere. So in this way, we got first of all IPH, then power factor, then PQS. Acknowledgement, textbook Electrical Technology by B.L. Theraja. Thank you.